I need to find a solution to all this nervous energy. I drank too much coffee today. So I was on YouTube looking at all these fidget spinners. The problem is if I order one, it won't be here until next week. And I need to solve my nervous energy problem now. So I think I'm going to build a fidget spinner. Let's get started, give it a try. This is going to be a fairly simple build. We're going to be reusing some of the bearings that we have from our dolly slider that we made in a previous episode. You may want to check that video out too, because it's a really neat product. But we had some leftover bearings, so I wanted to use them for something. I thought, what a great idea to calm my nerves and make a fidget spinner. Make sure that you take your bearings. These are R8, 22 millimeter on the outside, 8 millimeter on the inside, and dip them in acetone to get the packing grease off of them. They move a lot smoother once you remove the grease from them. Again, make sure you remove the grease by dipping them in acetone for a while and then wiping them off. This is gonna be a really easy build. The way we get started is we go File, New, Part, pick a plane, right-click on top plane, sketch. Then we're gonna select a slot, and I'm gonna use straight slot. Select the origin, make sure it's vertical, click again, and now select a width. And these are just arbitrary until we dimension them. Then we're gonna put two holes in for our bearing. And based on our last design, a snug fit is somewhere around 0.86 inches for these bearings. So to compensate a little bit more, because they were a little loose in the last one, I'm gonna do 0.858, just 2,000 smaller. And we're going to make this equal these two circles. So we go select this circle, select that circle, equal. Now they're the same size. Now we have to pick a dimension for our outer diameter. And at 8.6, 0.65 looks okay, or 0.625 I would say would probably be a good. I'm gonna go a little thicker. Just make it 0.7. Yeah, I like that a little bit better. And now all we need is a length. Now I had measured a distance of my hand and came up with about 1.5. 1.75 may not be bad either. Let's do we can always make more than one. But no, 1.5 looks good. Let's stick with that. The next thing we're gonna do is feature, extrude at base, and we're gonna do midpoint like I always do. We're gonna be using 3/8 inch acrylic because that's what I have. So 3 divided by 8, 3/8, and there's our acrylic. Now you may notice I have 4 bearings, but we've only created one, enough to hold 2 bearings or one side. Watch what I do. This is something new. So I'm gonna go to reference geometry, and I'm gonna select axis. I'm gonna select this circle. It now just put an axis through the center of the circle. You can extend it just by grabbing its lines. So now we have an axis through, and it's just so you can see that better. There you go. We have an axis through the hole. We could go back to features, go to linear pattern, and underneath of it select circular pattern. And I'm gonna want 3 of these, including the original, equal spacing 360 degrees. So watch. For the parameter, I'm gonna select our axis. For the features, I'm gonna select the part. And look how easy that was to make. So there's our fidget spinner, and all we have to do is press fit these bearings into it. To make it a little nicer, we'll add some fillets. Remember, fillets always are a nice way to clean up a design. 0.25 we'll call it, just because I'm guessing to see what that looks like. Yeah, that's not bad. And there we go. We can pull our bearing out from a previous design and make an assembly, insert component. Now we're gonna do the bearing as the first, and I'll show you why. So the bearing is now mounted. That's our center bearing. Let's bring in the spinner. Here's the spinner. They're not attached yet. Watch what happens. If we go mate, select that circle, select this. pulls it together. And now, one more mate we need to do. The center of the spinner and the center of the bearing so that we can line them up. And you now see that it's aligned nicely. One thing I noticed is it's a little thick. I may want to use a little smaller of a material. See, that's why we do assemblies. So let's go in and let's just try 1/4 inch material. Yeah, and that's a little bit better. So that looks good. The other thing we want to do is define our material. You should define it as acrylic, but the acrylic tends to be transparent looking in SOLIDWORKS, so I'm gonna select a different plastic. I am gonna select ABS, apply that. Now it's white, for some reason they like white ABS, but I'm just gonna change the color to black. So there we are. Now if we go back to our assembly, there's our fidget spinner. Now here's what we can do. Bring in 3 bearings. There's a number of ways to do this, but this is just quick and easy for me. 3 bearings. We made them. 1. Mate this one to that hole. Doesn't matter which one you do. And mate this one to that hole. Now, rather than selecting a plane, I'll just select the top surfaces of the bearings. And you'll notice it pulls them all equally level. And had I selected the spinner itself, the top of the bearing would have been equal to this top, but then it would have been sticking out the bottom. So there you go. And that pretty much is our spinner. That includes the design portion of it. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna cut this out on the laser cutter, and hopefully it works. It's such a simple product, it shouldn't really take any time at all to get it working. So let's give it a try. We'll go over to the laser cutter. We're ready to cut the fidget spinner on our laser cutter, but Denny's not here today, so it looks like I'm on my own. I think I can handle it. But hopefully I can handle it. I don't cause any problems like a fire or something like that. You do have to be careful. If you forget to put the air on, they will catch the parts on fire. The air helps. Some laser cutters actually use nitrogen to even cut down on the flames further. So just remember to be safe with them. We've been very lucky so far. It's been working and reliable, but you know, make sure you don't do anything stupid and catch the place on fire. Let's get started. This has got to be the easiest project that we've done so far. It literally is just this one piece of acrylic. And if you know anything about my designs, this isn't good enough. It's simple, but I just want to add a couple of little more features to it to make it more me, more my design. This is too plain for me. So I'm going to get back to the computer, and through the magic of editing, you're going to see me with a finished product that looks just a little bit better. So it's a good idea to take a few extra minutes, put in that extra time so that you can make the best product possible. So I'm quickly going to go through this and just add one simple feature. I'm going to cut out some of the center of the fidget just so that it has a style to it. We took an extra 5 minutes to add some detail and took this product that I originally designed and made it look like this. It may seem like a small step, but that little extra effort goes a long way. If you can't figure out how to put this thing together, you should own a laser cutter, but I'll show you anyhow. Now remember, laser cutter's beams are slightly angled because they focus, they're like a regular lens. So they have a slight taper to them, so you gotta find which side the bearing goes in easier. If it was designed right, it should just snap right in. So there's one. There's 2, and I find that this side makes it really easy. If I try from the other side, it's hard. 3, 4, and that's it. There's our spinner. You can see it works. Now maybe some of my nervous habits will go away. My nerves are finally calming down. I hope you've enjoyed this episode of Invention Therapy. Be sure to subscribe by hitting the button down below and join us next time where we build another cool product.